Hello everyone, this video may be triggering to some of you. Now it's about statistics, so I'd like for you to stay to the end and comment and subscribe and make sure you share because this needs to get out and I'll catch you on the next one.
Yeah, the worst thing about my pregnancy is that I'm always out of breath. I could walk from here to the end of the room and I'd feel like I'm dying. Like I went to my midwife and I was like, oh my God, like is this normal? I don't understand. She was like, yeah, you're carrying a child. There's a whole human inside of you. The baby is eating. Like, I feel like the baby's eating me. Like, that's the worst thing. It's so hard. It looks easy, guys. It is easy to a certain extent, but it's hard. I'm not even going to lie to you.
That was Nicole Thea, a 24-year-old YouTuber from London. She was 8 months pregnant with her son, Rain, and died suddenly on Saturday, July 13th. At the time, the cause of death was not revealed. However, it is now reported that she died of a massive heart attack. This unfortunate trend has been ongoing for a while, and I wanted to give you some statistics that should be troubling to us all. Black women are 3 to 4 times more likely at risk of pregnancy-related deaths than white women, which continues to increase, as well as 243% likelier to die of childbirth or pregnancy-related causes. The cause stems from a lack of access, poor quality care, and Black women are undervalued in the healthcare system. This was brought to the public's attention by celebrities like Serena Williams, who almost died due to a medical neglect and her doctors not believing her pain was real. Here she is.
Someone said that our little girl was going to win Wimbledon in like 15, 20 years.
Not if I'm still on tour.
You're ridiculous.
Everything went great, and I put a little makeup on so I could take pictures with the baby. And I just remember getting up, and I couldn't breathe. And I was like, I can't breathe. Like, I couldn't take a deep breath. I told the nurse, I can't breathe. I need a mask. So I put the oxygen mask on, and I started coughing because I couldn't breathe. It hurt so bad. It hurt so bad that my stitches broke. And I remember I was in the bathroom with my mom, and I was just crying and crying, and she was crying. She's like, you just gotta breathe. And I was like, I can't breathe. And it was just really hard. After that, I remember being wheeled back to the operating room because they had to reopen my C-section and re-stitch it. And then they had to check for, you know, blood clots and everything. So they were doing all these different tests and everything was negative. I'm like, listen, I need you to run a CAT scan with dye because I have a pulmonary embolism in my lungs. I know it. I know I've had this before. I know my body.
She was undoubtedly battling for her life, and I was terrified that she might die. But I was grateful that she had the wherewithal to speak up because she knew her body better than any of us.
The enormity of everything was scary. But fortunately, because she advocated for herself, they ended up taking her in for a CAT scan and they found the pulmonary embolism.
Every day I was in the operating room for something different. You know, it was one thing after another, and eventually I got another blood clot in my leg. So the decision was going in for a third surgery where they put a filter in me that blocks blood clots from being able to get up to my heart. I was so healthy. My pregnancy was so easy. Like, I didn't have any problems. But unfortunately, once I had the C-section, everything from there was pretty much a nightmare.
In the case of Beyonce, her pregnancy with her twins was traumatic due to her developing high blood pressure, which led to preeclampsia, along with one of the twins having a heart issue, resulting in her getting a C-section where she spent months recovering and in the neonatal unit. With Nicole, she mentioned that she expressed her discomfort and issues to the midwife, and she was basically told it was par for the course. And now, like so many other Black pregnant women, she and her unborn son are dead. This needs to stop. There is this notion in the healthcare system that Black women don't feel pain the same way as our Caucasian sisters do. And I myself has experienced this during a doctor's visit, where I was told that my pain should not be as excruciating as it is because you are all quote unquote strong. So I should be able to tolerate it and I don't need any medication. Needless to say, that so-called doctor was not allowed to treat me, and a report was filed with the hospital. You see, we all feel pain the exact same way, no matter the color of our skin. It's a tragedy that this young 24-year-old woman lost her life on account of someone's implicit bias, medical neglect, and sincere ignorance. All women should be treasured and valued the same way. Because after all, we are the vessels chosen to bring humankind to this planet, and we should be protected at all costs. Comment below if you think that this could have been prevented. Also, remember to like this video, subscribe if you haven't, and share, and I will catch you in the next one. Goodbye.